Tonight for the Panthers of Lakeside-Evans.
Alec Leesburg, that's their talented offensive lineman and linebacker that Coach Dudley mentioned. Those are your seniors for the Lakeside Panthers. For the Gators, we have Cameron Gibson, we have Jamel McBride, we have Xavier Tobler and Issa Lowe. Let's give it down to Scott, who's walking out with them right now. Scott?
Guys, shake hands, introduce yourselves to each other. All right, guys, y'all been late in the cat this night, okay? So, okay, look at what we have to say. Let's get a correct answer from you. Look at your coach. What answer you do say is what I'm going to go with, okay? White, you are the visitor team tonight. Green, you're the home team tonight. There's a heads right here, and this is a tails. I'm going to toss it there. What would you like me? What would you like?
Tails.
He said tails, okay? Here we go. Tails, he said. And it is heads. You've won the toss. You can kick, receive, defend, or defer to the second half.
Defer to the second
okay.
half.
Okay. Green has won the toss. Has deferred. Deferred. Okay. Which way you want to receive the ball? On the other side over there? Okay. Y'all step over here. Y'all face each other, and we'll get it.
Yeah.
All right. Here we go. Green won the toss. Has deferred. And we'll be kicking. Okay. Get your kicking team, receive team. Let's have a good game.
All right. Well, another win-win.
Todd, I hope he buys me a lottery ticket tonight.
Yeah, but here's the kicker, though. He won't come up with the numbers for you. You're going to have to come up with
them. That's right.
Oh, man.
He will bless your numbers.
Well, with all my water whipmail and wisdom and my luck here lately, I'll be hitting a big number tonight. Ware County's going to beat a big number, y'all.
All right. So we won the toss, deferred to the second half, which is our MO all year. We're about to get the kickoff here going in about 2.5 minutes or so. By the way, the Pierce Central Carroll game kickoff has been moved to 8. That was made Wednesday, that decision. If you're in the area wondering about that game for travel purposes, that is going to be at 8 o'clock tonight across the river. It's 10 seconds right now for station identification, and you're listening to Ware County Gator Football.
WKUB, Blackshear, Waycross.
At Waters Ford, we'll always take care of you.
Back at Memorial Stadium, Brian Blunt, Clay Thomas, Omar Oliver in the box. Scott Tanner on the Gators sidelines. Seth Starling tees it up as he loves to do on the left hash as we go right to left this first half. They got a couple of guys back deep. We're dressed in our green jerseys, gold breeches, and Lakeside-Evans is in all white. Starling boots it. This is a low knuckleball that's going to go out of bounds at the 3-yard line, but it should be a penalty. The player actually went over. I was wondering if he was going to grab it before it actually made it out of bounds. Stephen Huzzah, who is a sophomore wide receiver, but that'll bring it out to the 35. Went out of bounds right at the 3. So excellent field position, Clay, for Lakeside-Evans to start this game.
Yeah, there's been some discussion about, they kind of equate it to golf, and him might having the mental yips right now. Not with his extra points, but kicking off has been a struggle for him here lately.
First and 10, the quarterback's a junior, Hunter Banks. He goes to the gun immediately with actually the pistol with one setback. Now they look over to get the signs. This looks familiar, doesn't it? Josh Jones is your sophomore running back. More of a gun. Now they're going to stack the receivers, twins on both sides. Four receivers from the 35. Hand off to the running back. He's got room. 40, 45, midfield. We drag him down around the 47. We're worried about the passing game, so immediately they hand off to Josh Jones. Get a first down all the way down to the 47 of Ware County. The chains move on the first play of the game.
And for all practical purposes, he was untouched until the tackle. So he went 8 or 9 yards without even being touched.
Secondary had to come up to make the tackle. They're at our 48-yard line. Play action. Quick out here. Complete at our 45. Oh, he gets hit by Mills, then goes down with the cavalry coming in to finish him off at the 41. But gain of 7 on there for number 20. That's B.J. Raymond, a sophomore wide receiver. A lot of young players. But they love to move the ball out of this spread. And look at this, already the nose of the ball right at our 40-yard line. And it is second down, 3. Nothing. Lakeside-Evans opening offensive series of the night against Ware County. True spread now. 5 receivers. Swings it out. Left side complete to the 40. Breaks at 1 tackle. Then we just gang him right there at the 37. Should be a first down. Jonathan Edwards, the junior running back, on the reception there. Chains move. Let's move it down to Scott on the field, Scott.
Man, I wasn't expecting that. They are multidimensional like y'all were hoping Ware County is going to be this year, and I think we're going to have to answer that call with a bunch of different looks.
At the 37-yard line of the Gators, first and 10, chains move. Quarterback goes under center real quickly, and then he fakes that, and then he comes out of it. And it's a direct snap to a running back who gets 5. He gets 7. A little trickeration going on with Josh Jones, the quarterback. Was walking towards the sidelines like he was going to get the play called in from the line. They did a direct snap to the running back and got 8 yards. Second down, 1.5 yards. Lakeside on the move. Trips on the right. Swinging out. Complete and drops. Incomplete. Well, he was looking, B.J. Raymond, where to run. He had a couple of wide receiver blockers in front of him, but he heard some footsteps, some from Tobler and Rolfe. So finally, they get some type stoppage going here, Clay.
Yeah, this is a scripted series. You can tell this was a planned scripted series. They knew what they were going to do as they marched down the field, and they've only thrown quick screens. That's all they've thrown.
At the 28, third down, 1.5 yards. 28 aware, low snap. Bobbled handoff to the running back, and we just eat him up. He didn't get back to the line, Jonathan Edwards. So now what do you do here? I don't know what kind of kicking game they have, but this would be a long one even for a really polished kicker. The spot, the 30. Loss of a couple brings up 4th and 3.5 now.
I think they're just going for it.
Yeah. They're late coming in with the play. They have Forrest Nanny coming in and Kendall White going out. They're really late getting set here at their 30 of Ware. Crowd getting to its feet on the home side. Looking for a defensive stand from the gun. Quarterback Banks takes the snap. Little cross buck inside. Tobler gets him. Loss of a couple. Oh, he didn't really stand a chance. Did a little inside reverse to Josh Jones, and Tobler's is 80.
Yeah, and that series, everybody at home, don't panic. We're just fine. that was a scripted series. They knew the first 10 plays of the game, and they were somewhat one-dimensional, and only being able to throw those quick screens, we made adjustments, and our offense is on the field.
At the 32 of the Gators, we take over on offense. Nothing. Lakeside-Evans and Ware. We go to the gun immediately. One setback. Well, we do the little hard count thing. Nobody moves. And then we look to the sidelines, only we're doing it to get a play. Jamar Johnson back to pass. Swings it out quickly to Burley. Breaks a tackle. 35-40. 45, they angle in midfield. Get him at the 45-yard line of Lakeside-Evans. One of their captains, Javon Brigham, the senior linebacker, had to come up from behind and ride Burley down. But look at the gain all the way to the 44. We do one play, and we get one first down.
And that was a true pass down the field in which they look over to see way too much cushion on our receiver. Plenty of room to maneuver.
Inside the 44 of Lakeside, first and 10 Ware on the left hash, going right to left. Jamar's under center, does a hard count, and then looks to the sidelines. We like doing this. We've done it forever, it seems like. Now he shifts back to the gun. At the 44, first and 10 Ware. from the gun. Handoff. This is Tobler. He does a little counter move. Gets some blocking and gets down inside the 40, inside the 39, maybe the 38. Give him 5.5 or 6 on that. Second down. Good yardage.
And in comes McBride, and we bring out hit. And McBride comes in, and I think McBride was actually an offensive player of the week last week, and he only played 15 or 16 plays.
The Ware County High School stream team doing its thing, sponsored by Robbie Robertson Ford and Tendo Enterprises through the auspices of the Ware County Touchdown Club. This will be archived on their website later tonight. At the 38, 2nd and 4. Dudley in motion. We move early, and that's going to cost us. On the left side of the line, just a little early. Antsy movement is going to cost us 5. Let's go downstairs to Scott.
Well, me and Bo Carter were talking just then. We wouldn't, neither one of us were expecting this, but Omar kind of hit on it, you know. We passed all the easy games now. It's just going to be headhunting from here on out.
Oh, absolutely. This reminds you of being in a tougher region, like the region ones of the past, or if they're in the southwest part of the state.
Ain't that the truth? And, that, you know, you're talking about Daugherty County and, you know, Bainbridge and Cairo, back in their heyday, they were tough.
So, loss of 5 on the penalty, if you will. The mark off might still remain 2nd down, but now it's 2nd and 9 at the 43 of Lakeside. Just a procedure penalty. Delay, handoff to Tobler, bounces to the right, breaks a tackle down at the 33-yard line. Wow, and gain of 10 right there. That should be a first down.
Yeah, and he did get the first down, and we're having a lot of success running between the tackles, and they're pursuing both of their defensive ends on straight angles, and so we put a fullback H-back out there to handle one, and we've had plenty of room in the middle to run the football.
We're on the right hash, scoreless game, but Ware County on the drive here inside the 33 of Lakeside Evans. First and 10, change move as we go right to left. Now out of the eye. And we got Isolow in motion to the left. Play action, rolling right. He's looking right. He fires out of bounds, incomplete. Didn't have anybody. They had our receiver well defended. Burley down around the 15-yard line, well covered, so Jamar just chunked it out of bounds, incomplete pass.
And I like Jamar's decision. That's a young quarterback or a quarterback at the beginning of the year. He tries to make something happen or he runs and he fumbles. Jamar just takes the ball and just flobs it out of bounds, and that's a quarterback who's growing before our eyes.
2nd down and 10 at the 33 of Lakeside Evans. Scoreless game, Gators on offense, again from the eye. Again, low in motion, left side. Play action, he's rolling left. He's looking, fires, underneath, incomplete. A diving receiver down around the 25 was Isolow going on a little out pattern, but it was just a little bit low. He couldn't go down to get it. Brings up 3rd and 10.
That's not a perfect pass, but Isolow would tell you he should catch that ball. It would have been a tough catch, but Isolow would tell you he should catch that ball.
Tobler comes back in. Now we're going wide left, slot left, wide right, and wing right. From the gun, Tobler is your lone setback. Johnson at the 33. Looks to get the play. The whole team just turns over to the sidelines to get the read. From the 33, back to pass in the pocket. Looks like he wants to throw a screen. Now he's being rushed. He's going to run with it. 30, 25, breaks a tackle, dives for the 20, and that's a first down.
Oh, wow. I had to hold my breath on that one. It looks like he was going to be sacked behind the line, and he just cuts it upfield. We're seeing an offensive style that we've not seen this year, where they actually just ask him to drop back and look downfield to look for the receiver. He didn't see anything and cut it upfield and just made things happen on his own. That's what Dudley was talking about, having that athleticism at quarterback that defenses have to be accountable for.
The ball is spot a foot shy of the 20. Change move, 1st and 10. Ware on the move with 7:12 left already in this first period against Lakeside Evans out of Evans in the Augusta area. Under center now. Handoff Tobler. He slams on brakes, finds his way through the gap and gets about 8 yards down to the 12-yard line, pushing the defense backwards, especially getting off the bottom. It's number 33, Rashad Roundtree, who came up out of the secondary to help make the tackle, coming up from behind Javon Brigham, the linebacker. The gain inside the 13, call it 2nd and short. 2nd down, 2 two and a half. We're on the left hash now. And Jamar goes under center, puts Dudley, or rather Burley, left to right. Again, handoff Topler. Again, he slams on brakes. This time they have time to penetrate and stop him. Brigham on the tackle. Gain of maybe a yard for Xavier, just straight up the gut. We're trying to use some power in there. Well, they're going to give him a good spot down to the 10. That might be a first down. Yeah, it is. Wow, he got further than I thought. Let's go down to Scott.
Oh, man, that was awesome running. That kid there is just impressed, that young man. As we were just talking, that interview he did with Brian, he couldn't even sit still the other day. He's putting so much energy in, you know. He's doing that on the football field, and it's, the other guys are, you know, soaking it up. So here we go, Brian.
First and goal, right on the 10-yard line. Togler gets the first down. Gators knocking on the door midway here in this first period already from the gun. On a speed sweep, Jenkins right side, gets a block. Oh, a penalty goes down as he goes in the end zone, but it's coming back. Holding against Ware. And it's going to be marked around the 13, so probably around the 23-yard line. We ran a speed sweep to Jenkins left to right, and somebody got caught doing something wrong.
Yeah, and I believe it was one of our running backs that was trying to help his friend a little bit, but it's one of those, I'm not sure that the hold was necessary. I still think the play would have been successful, but that player has quickly come out of the game.
The spot, the 24-yard line of Lakeside, still remains first, but goal. Got to get it in the end zone here or run out of downs. We're going to load up the right side, it appears, with the receiving core for the most part. Burley out here on the left. Nothing Ware and Lakeside Evans. We just had a holding penalty set us back. Now we got Bailey in motion to the left. He's in the slot. Quick out. That's low on the right side. A little hitch and gets knocked out inside the 20, close to the 19. So only give him about five on that. Brings up second and goal.
And when you look at, you know, second and 19 yards, you really just have to take it off a bite at a time, a bite at a time. So right here, we just need to pick up another 6 or 7 yards so we can make it third and manageable.
Second and goal at the 19, gain of five on that pass from Johnson to Lowe. Now we go a little mini huddle, and Burley's kind of left out of it over here on the left. Now watch, you know the ball's coming to him. Bailey in motion from the 19. Rolling to his left. Jamar has room to run if he wants to, and he does. 20, 15, down the sideline and knocked out around the 10. He was looking for Burley all the way on that.
But I think, Brian, he picked up close to 8 or 9 yards.
He did.
There. So this is what you've got to do, is just slowly chop it away when you get in those types of positions.
So it's now third and goal at the 10 of Lakeside Evans. Nothing Gators and Panthers. We're knocking on the door, but a holding penalty hurt us on what would have been an apparent touchdown run. Jamar Johnson under center, out of the eye. Wide right, slot right on this one from the left hash. They're in a tight 4-3. Play action, rolling right, looking in the end zone. He's going to put it down. He's going to run. He's going to get close, and they're going to save the day and get him right around the 3-yard line. One guy blew in over there. I think that was Hauser over there.
It was, Brian.
Halza, or however you pronounce that, all the way to the third. We're going to bring out the kicking core to try a three-point.
And that's a tough decision for a coach to make. But, you know, most of the idea is to get your points on the board, but Dudley sometimes has things up his hat, up his sleeve with these types of scenarios. But, you know, we're 3 yards away from 6 points.
This is like a point after, but it is a field goal attempt of 20 yards by Seth Starling from the right hash. Falk to hold. And Starling to try. We got to the 3, but got stops. Good snap and set, and good kick. So Ware on the board first tonight, 3-0 over Lakeside Evans. 30-second timeout. You're listening to Gator Football.
Hey, Gator fans. Experience a winning team when you purchase a vehicle from Walker Jones in Waycross. An unbeatable lineup of Chevys, Buicks, Hondas, Toyotas, Chryslers, Jeeps, Dodges, and Rams. With state-of-the-art body repair shop and 40 service bays. Latest high-tech diagnostics and a huge parts department. Located on US 1 South in Waycross. Walker Jones. We've got it all, so why shop anywhere else? Walker Jones and team wish the Gators a winning season.
Get the best deal from Walker Jones.
Back at Memorial Stadium, downstairs to Scott.
Well, I like our kicking game for tonight, and if it comes down to 3 points, I've got all the confidence in Seth Starling. Our punt game is so spot on with John Bennett right now, so let's hope it don't come down to that guy.
Well, one thing to consider too, Clay, is look how late it is in the quarter. You do need points. If possessions are going to last that long, you better get points.
No doubt. That was the right move.
Starling boots it. This is longer, but it's going to fall short of the end zone. Kalza at the 5'10", doing all kinds of jukin' and jiving, 15-20. Got a little bit of a lane up on the right sideline, up around the 25, 26-yard line.
Yeah, and that was good coverage, good protection. We surrounded the returner very well. We had that, what I call the half moon shaped around him. So that was good. And Seth was probably about 4.5 yards from putting that in the end zone. So he's still shaking his head. He doesn't know what's happened and why he's not putting him in the end zone.
Thompson and Mills and Bailey in there to tackle at the 25, first and 10. And a little play action fake, quick out complete to a receiver who gets 5 yards. We eat him up. That's Jonathan Edwards. Oh, it was like one of those little hard tuck handoff fakes, and quarterback Banks really slung it out to Edwards and got a solid five across the 30. Brings up second and 5. 3-0, Ware leading, but Lakeside-Evans with the ball. From the pistol, as they also are guilty of doing the hard count thing to see if you can get a cheap 5 yards. Now back in a gun. Four receivers, one setback for Banks. The setback is Josh Jones, just a sophomore. From their own 30, Gators leading 3-0. Long count, good snap. Back to pass, play action. We rush. He throws, incomplete. Oh, he had a man on a delay, streaking open the running back, Jones. Had he been able to connect it, that might have been six.
Yeah, that was a wheel route that he came out of the end zone with, I mean, out of the backfield with, and he had the whole sideline. We did get a lot of pressure on the quarterback, and that's the only thing that kept that, I think, from being 6 points.
Yeah, we ran a chance blitz on that. Left Jones wide open, so the right call to just misconnect. Trips on the right now, third and 5 at the 30. Snap to Banks. Delay, draw, and we stopped the running back 2 yards shy. Jones could not get to the first down marker. Let's see what they do here. I would imagine they'll punt. Down only 3-0 to Ware. Let's go down to Scott.
Yeah, I think you're exactly right. This early in the quarter, they're going to punt right now, but you're exactly right about the possession time. You know, the offense and defense are controlling the clock just as much. This offense, they went almost 3 minutes the last time the Gators had the ball.
So they're showing punt. We put a guy back at our 30, 3-0 Gators lead. Their punter standing inside of their 20. And that's Tanner Durand, and he boots it. Nice kick. Wilkins going to have to let it bounce. It bounces sideways a little bit in Lakeside's favor down across our 30-yard line. Do remember the Tommy Palmer scoreboard. It comes your way at 10 o'clock or at the conclusion of this game, whichever is later. We're going to start first and 10 across our own 30. We'll call it the 31-yard line. Ware County leading Lakeside-Evans 3-0, first quarter action with 2:38 left in the first period.
You know, I would say this about their offense. It is a pretty sophisticated offense. They have a lot of different formations and a lot of forms, but so far our defense has seemed to address it pretty well.
On the left hash, at the 31 aware. Gators up by a field goal. Johnson under center. Dudley in motion, and it's Burley in motion. And a straight handoff to Tobler, breaks a tackle. If he can get another block, but he can't. Man, a great response by Steven Hauser. Down around the 25-yard line. Tobler broke a tackle. If he could have gotten one more block on Hauser, but he lost 3 or 4 yards back to the 27-yard line. Just a play that went south right from the get-go.
And Jamar was trying to come back to spring him a block so he could cut it out wide, but in the process we ended up losing probably 3.5 yards.
So Lakeside-Evans showing some speed here.
Absolutely. Not a big team, but a very fast team and well-coached, well-disciplined.
At the 27, second and 14, 3-0 Ware leading. We go to a pistol. Jamar, options, right side pitch to Tobler, spin move. He's going to get a couple, and then the white jersey's going to eat him up. We just cannot get the blocking on their line over there. Linebackers coming up, number 19, Javon Brigham, the senior, the captain, helping to finish it off at the 29. That brings up third down, 11.
We got to remember, these guys play what is probably the toughest region in 5A football. So they're accustomed to high levels of competition. So Ware County does not intimidate them whatsoever.
At the 29, third and 11, 3-0, Ware leading Lakeside-Evans. Panthers really showing some spunk tonight. Bailey in motion from the gun. Johnson rolling to his right. Looks, fires, high, is complete, caught. They're going to give it to him, yeah. And a first down at the 41 by Heist Low and out of bounds.
Now that's a big-time high school football pass. Rolling to his right. Threads the needle, hits Isa Lowe right at the first down marker, and Isa has just enough room to put his foot down on a long out pattern to the far sideline.
B.J. Raymond right there, step for step. But like Clay said, it was perfect throw, perfect catch. Tiptoe going out of bounds just past the marker. At the 41-yard line of the Gators, new life, new set of downs. 3-0, Ware leading late now in the first period over Lakeside-Evans. We're going to an I formation. Burley is on an island by himself out here on the left, wide side. From the right hash, 1:03 remaining. Clock has stopped in the quarter. Oh, we dropped the ball in the snap, and Jamar gets right back on it, so we just lose it down and maybe a half a yard.
And they are, the defense they're running, if you're listening at home, their defense is saying, you will have to throw the ball. We're not going to let you just run down our throat. So Isa Lowe right now is in isolation. In other words, it's zero coverage. The guy guarding him has no real safety help behind, and we're going to have to take advantage of that.
Second down, 10.5 from the eye. Dudley in motion now. And we hand it off. This is Tobler finding a running room up to midfield and down. Oh, Brigham had to come up and get him from behind. Otherwise, he would have taken it to the house. Gain of right at 10, but remember, we lost yardage. So we need a foot, I think.
They're stacking 9 people in the box, and that's in that formation. That's as many as you can put in without leaving a receiver open. And they're saying, we dare you to run, and we're still running, and fairly effectively.
Inside Lakeside territory. Quarterback sneaking, we got it. And that's going to end the quarter. Johnson snuck it for a yard and a half. When time resumes, we don't have far to change sides of the field here. We've completed one quarter of play. It's 3-0, Ware leading Lakeside-Evans. 30-second timeout. You're listening to Gator Football.
McDonald's of Waycross is family-owned and operated by Phase 2 Management Group, also serving Blackshear, Folkston, Kingsland, Georgia, and Callahan, Florida. Check out our dollar menu for values at any time of the day. We're now open 24 hours. Visit a McDonald's McCafe for a refreshing frozen strawberry lemonade or ice-cold frappe. Stop by your local Fay Family McDonald's location today, and go Gators!
Back at Memorial Stadium, Brian Blunt with Clay Thomas, Omar Oliver up in the sky. Scott Tanner on the sidelines. It's not getting chilly, is it, Scott?
Yeah, no, I got a cup of coffee in my hand here.
All right.
And, I tell you what, this is tougher start than what I thought it was going to be for these Panthers. They really, like Clay said, run such a sophisticated offense. It's going to take a little while for Jimmy to figure it out, but I got all the confidence in Jimmy.
Yeah, and the scores are not real indicative of how good they are. I mean, Northside laid it on them in the 50s to nothing, I think.
But Northside lays everybody.
Everybody, yeah.
So you can't. At Glen Academy 7, Jones County 0 at this time.
I figure that's probably the game of the week, to be honest.
It should be tight.
Yeah. That's about the most even matchup in our area. Of course, right now, you're looking at a 3-0 score. This is an even matchup. Ware and Lakeside-Evans. Second quarter action. We're at the 47, first and 10 Gators. Jamar, handoff. This is a back trying to break through and go down at the 44-yard line. Gain of 3 for Tobler. Just trying to look in.
And I want to make sure I'm painting the appropriate picture, but Lakeside is saying, Jamar Johnson, you're going to have an active role in this game for your team to be successful. And so far, so good. Jamar's handled it just fine.
Well, he's certainly scrambled more tonight than I think we've seen him this season. He'll have to keep that up from under center now. Second down, 7. 3-0, Ware leading.
They're about to bring the house, is what they just showed. Both linebackers blitzing.
Now they backed off from that. Second and 7 inside the 45. They're showing it again on the outside. Quick out to the right, incomplete. Oh, Lowe heard the footsteps coming. 28 is Howza. We're trying to get some blocking going out here with the wide receivers.
Yeah, that was one of those real quick hits that we just throw it immediately to him at his where he's at, actually lined up in his receiver position and asked the other receiver to block for him and just really in and out of the hands of Isolow, although Lakeside really had that well defended if he would have caught the ball.
Third down, seven at the 44 of the Panthers. 3-0, Ware leading. Second quarter just begun here. True spread now. Quads on the right. We interrupt that. Send one to the left. Johnson snap. Rolls right. Looks. Fires down the sideline. He's got Loven out of bounds. Oh, my. Right around the 18-yard line. Well defended down there. Again, Tanner Brassel coming over. Had some good company with Isolow. He was open. Just ran out of real estate right around the 18. Incomplete pass. So Bennett is going to come in for the first time tonight. And we go to this shift thing that we like to do on extra points.
But we're not lined up over the ball.
And now we shift to a punt formation. Yeah, that was rather interesting. They put a man deep back inside their 10. 3-0, Ware leading. We're having to give them back the ball. Good snap. Kick. Beautiful kick.
Perfect.
Out of bounds with it. Go, yeah, right to Scott at the 6-7 yard line. So Bennett does another great coffin corner, and let's go down to Scott.
Hey, I got the football in my hand.
I see that.
I landed in
you know
thing
you
got
to give him back that thing.
Now, I was going to get Tober to sign that if he got a touchdown on this drive coming up. We're going to see what they got with the backs against the wall right here with these Panthers. They're showing a lot of stunting and stuff on defense, and we still haven't picked up on it yet.
At the 7. First and 10, Lakeside banks their quarterback with two setbacks this time. 3-0 Ware. Handoff to one of those backs around the right side. That's Edwards. The ball's fumbled. There's nothing but green, and we get it at the 20.
And that's one of those plays where we were all tempted to try to pick it up and score, but they did the smart thing by just jumping on it.
And that was Porter who came up with it. Ely helped get it as well. But credit Tremont Porter with the fumble recovery. Somebody really racked Edwards. The ball came out. And we have it at the 20 of Lakeside.
That's what a punting game can do for you. Don't forget to give Mr. Bennett a little credit, putting them back in the corner. And now we've got the ball in great field position.
First and 10 Ware, 3-0. Turnover to us on a fumble. Under center, out of the eye, Jamar. Play action, rolls right, has room, throws instead, has complete. His man, complete low, breaks a tackle, breaks another, and down at the 2.
Wow. And I tell you, Isolow caught the ball.
In traffic.
He was a man possessed after he caught it and just got us down to the, I guess, what's that, Brian, the 2-yard line?
Yeah. First and goal, Gators. 10:28 clock running, 3-0. We're going left to right this period. We're knocking on the door from the right hash. High formation. Jamar under center. Handoff, Tobler. Troll, they just submarine and stop him. I don't know if he got any penetration.
I think he did.
It was short, but he did. 33 is in there for the Panthers just about every play.
And that's Rashawn Roundtree.
Yeah, he is just about in there.
And he's having to come up out of the secondary, as Clay's pointed out. They're really playing us tight. Of course, the field is compressed right here. You're right, he got inside the 1.
And Slater Hodge really doing a good job. Maybe they'll run behind him right here.
Jamara looks over the D like he's looking for a hole to run through, and he tries to get behind his people, and they may have stopped him short at the goal line.
Yeah,
he leaned up against his offensive line, and their backs, they were stood up. And then you saw Jamar stand up along. I think he actually lost a little yardage there.
They did. Big number 64 for the Panthers, the first man to hit him. He's submarined, Aubrey Wheeler.
Yeah, he's getting under our pads.
That's Micah Johnson, a junior lineman. And look at that. We're right there. The nose of the ball is right on the goal line. Third and goal, Gators. Jamar Johnson snap, handoff Tobler, he dives in for a touchdown.
And Gator fans. That makes it 9-0 with 9 minutes and 8 seconds left in the second quarter. As we just handed an ISO play off the right-hand side. And Togler has to fight, but he has good blocking to get us a 9-point advantage as we bring out Seth Starling to kick the extra point. Be Falk to hold and Wheeler to snap. This extra point is going to be sponsored by Kenny McCarthy. He just texted me. He's listening.
All right. I like that idea, sponsoring. Yeah.
And he's points. A good sponsor of ours, too, at Brownings.
That's true. That's true.
Now, if he shanks it, this is Kenny's fault.
Falk calls for it, gets the set. It's up, and it's a mile long and good.
Attaboy, Kenny.
10-0, we're leading Lakeside-Evans. 30-second timeout and station identification, and you're listening to Gator Football.
I feel good. Great service you can count on. We're always thinking of you. We got just what you're looking for.
Looking for the best deal on a Ford truck? You're gonna like us now at Robbie Robertson Ford. We have the deal you're gonna love. We'll make sure you get the most for your money. We have a great selection of Ford trucks, including the complete line of F-Series pickups. The only place to go is Robbie Robertson Ford, 2825 Memorial Drive in Waycross, serving Waycross for 11 years.
WKUB, Blackshear, Waycross.
At Waters Ford, we'll always take care of you.
Back at Memorial Stadium, a little bit of breathing room for the men in green after a turnover gave it to us at the 20-yard line. We punched it in. It's 10-0 Ware. Kickoff by Seth will be taken at the 5, right side 10, 15, 20. Finds some blocking, gets up to the 29-yard line. That's Halza on the return. Again, downstairs to Scott.
Man, there's some hard hitting popping going on down here. It reminds me of the Valdosta game, and Coffee was pretty physical too, but they're matching up pretty good with us right now.
Yeah, and I don't find this to be the game where, oh, it's 10-0 and Ware County's to run away with it. If you're listening at home, it doesn't have that feeling at all.
29, first and 10. Banks takes the snap from the gun, but the green wave penetrates, stops, no gain.
Some old light to come loose here, guys.
And that was Jalen Harrison, new running back in there, a sophomore. No gain, second down and 10 at the 29. Hurry up now. Quads on the right, double stacked. He looks, he fires, complete. Trying to get some blocking to Edwards to the 30. Oh, he get in on a good open field tackle. Coming over is Cat Jenkins on Edwards after he got just a few.
And just so you know at home, they're immediately throwing the ball to the wide receiver as he's still at the line, and then he's asking the other receivers to block upfield, and they do a phenomenal job of blocking upfield.
Gain of 4, third and 6 at the 33. Snap, Banks looks, fires right side, looking for some blocking. We're going to grab him, yeah, maybe short of by a yard. Tobler and Gibson coming up to get him, and I think he's going to be short. Let's see.
Looks like.
Oh, he's got it. Okay. Well, that gave him a good spot. It was going to be close anyway up there for B.J. Raymond.
I mean, they're throwing the ball to the receivers right at their spot. And what they're doing is just using the lane, and we're not able to get our outside linebacker over there quick enough. So we're going to have to play our linebackers out wider.
At the 39, first and 10, 10-0 Ware leading Lakeside-Evans, but the Panthers with the ball. Handoff. This is the back, Jones, around to the right side. Gets a couple up to the 41, maybe across it, give him 2.5. Tobler coming in to make the stop. And that'll bring up third down, or second rather, and 7, giving 3 on that.
The pace of this game is that one that we're not going to have a lot of possession, so you better score when you get the hands on the ball.
Even though they're kind of doing a hurry up on this series, double stacks here. And we might have jumped off. Yeah, they drew us off on the hard count. Must have been something a little different. So out we come. It's
Wayne 21, Baldwin nothing, and Appling 7, Rockmart 6.
Is this McBride wearing 68 tonight? Wayne Coleman in? Or who is that? At the 47. Oh, Collins, okay. Yeah.
McBride still got 98 on.
So it's second down and short now at the 47. Long count on this after the penalty. Play action back to pass in the pocket. Long down the right side and is almost intercepted. Incomplete. The receiver had to play defensive guy back there. We had Causer. Causer is incredible. You know, he plays in the secondary about as much as he plays linebacker.
It's unreal, Brian. I mean, he was step to step with him right there. It's like you said, looked like a basketball play.
Yeah. Forrest Nanny, the intended receiver, incomplete. So it's third down, 2.5 at the 47 of Lakeside. Slings it out. He's got a man complete. This is going to be a first down midfield and knocked down around the 46 of Ware by Porter and Tobler. And that was Edwards on the reception. So that moves the chains. Play. And
same play. They're the inside receiver. They're flexing him out to the sideline and throwing him the pass and asking the two outside receivers to block up field. That's leaving either our safety to make the tackle or Tobler all the way from the linebacker. We're going to have Cat Jenkins to step up and play that man.
Back to pass. No, it's a handoff, rather. A pass, okay, out quickly from the quarterback.
Yeah, took his head, huh?
That same quick flare pass
to Raymond. Got down to the 42-yard line. Brings up second down and 6, gain of 4. Lakeside on the move here, 10-0, Ware leading. But here come the guys in white, going right to left this quarter. Banks. Hard count, but no go. Jones in the backfield with him. And the snap to him and hand off to Jones, who slides on his cut, goes down after a yard. Just up the middle. Got Coleman getting off the bottom. And it'll bring up third down. And 6, 6.5. Finally, you got him in a little bit of a longer yardage situation. At the 42 aware, true spread, 5 receivers for quarterback Banks. Snap to him, back to pass, looks, has time, fires long, caught and down at the 18-yard line. Unbelievable catch for Edwards and triple coverage. We had Mills, Causer, and Jenkins back there. That was a nice thrown pass.
Right when he threw the ball, I said to myself, he shouldn't throw that ball. The next thing I know, it's a complete. I mean, he threw that into triple coverage. We really well defended, but just a great pass.
And the 18, he had time, too. We were in coverage with 5 receivers. He's got it again. From the 18 aware, snap to Banks. Looks right this time. Quick out complete to Raymond. Man, we really hit him and just jerk him to the ground. Calls are on the tackle there. Let's see where the spot will be. Close to the 15, I believe. Gain of 3. And brings up second down and 6 at the 14. Panthers knocking on the door. Gators leading 10-0, but here comes Lakeside. Snap to Banks, back to pass all day. Now he's got a lane, he's running, and he gets hit by Tobler and company down at the 5. That should be a first down.
Yeah, and this is a true spread offense. I mean, they spread it kind of like Oregon, and as soon as they get up from a play, they run back to those positions, and it's a very fast pace, and they're controlling the pace of the game right now, and typically our defense does not allow that to happen.
At the 6-yard line, first and goal. Lakeside knocking on the door here, down by 10, but they're in our red zone. Snap to Banks, handoff, driving over left tackle, and then we driving back, running with a couple of back set out of this formation.
And they're still not finding much between the tackles unless they spread us out all over the field and kind of sneak someone through the tackles. In other words, in a more of a basic formation, they're not able to run the ball on us. They have to really spread it out before they can run it.
Gain of a yard, second and goal at the 5. Again, 2 setbacks with Banks. He's going to hand off to Edwards, who does a little counter move, but he runs into a wall of green, and a flag goes in late. What is this?
I believe in where he threw it, that's got to be on us.
Right on the tackle.
It is.
Yeah, the Panthers are clapping. Jenkins comes out. Let's go downstairs to Scott.
Man, this isn't the place to make them kind of mistakes right there. And we're going to see this player come out of the game in just a second. He's fit good attitude adjustment. But you're right, Clay.
Blow to the head is the call.
Right. And both of y'all are right. Cat is just wasting himself out here. Jenkins is. He needs to snug up on these receivers because they telegraphing that pass in the flats.
They're showing second and goal. I guess it is. Second and goal at the three after the penalty. Snap the bangs. How we McBride. Key. McBride jumps all over the running back. No gain.
Yeah, he just beat his man through the gap, and I tell you, he just crawled all over his back and brought him down for a bit of a loss. So that blow to the head did not give them an automatic first down?
It must have not. They didn't indicate personal foul.
It fired McBride up for sure.
Yeah, Brigham on that carry.
Here we go, y'all.
They're using all kinds of running backs here. Third and goal at the three and a half. Crowd getting to its feet. Banks from a gun. Edwards in motion left to right. Banks rolls right, throws in the end zone, hands his man touchdown. Edwards coming out of the backfield. We were late getting over there. And a three-yard touchdown pass, or four-yard, we'll give him credit for.
And that leaves us with only 3 minutes and 8 seconds left to navigate in this second half as the score is 10-6 as we doing something we rarely have to do, and that's defend an extra point.
And that's Colby Ellis to try, the senior kicker. Good snap and set. It's up and good. 10-7. We're hanging on to a lead over Lakeside of Evans. 3:08 left in the half. 30-second timeout. You're listening to Gator Football.
Introducing HD Made Easy, only from MediaStream. HD channels are now included with your MediaStream Essential Value Cable Service. Enjoy dozens of channels in HD. No need for a cable box. Simply scan the channels with your HD television and uncover a wide selection of the best channels in high definition. No extra equipment, no extra remote, no extra charge, no early termination fee. MediaStream is bringing it home to you.
Call 283-2332 for details. 283-2332.
MediaStream.
Back at Memorial Stadium, where things have gotten just a little tighter now. 10-7. Ware leading Lakeside Evans. Kicking off will be Ellis. We put Isolo back deep. Quay Taylor in there as well. So you know Lakeside's fired up. They've been hitting on all cylinders here tonight with just an exception of a mistake or two. That fumble really cost them now. Kicker boots it. It's going to come short.
Ivy
takes it at the 10, 15, 20, no. He gets tackled at the 19-yard line by Daniel Cotty, a junior linebacker and H-back. Yeah. Well, let's see, Scott, where are you at down there?
I'm right back where the Gators are going to be playing at.
So you may want to go over there and nudge Dr. Rob Likens. I see him on the sideline. You know, he's retired. I'm wondering if – I think he's coming to more games now that he's retired.
He has, you know, and he said he's catching up on that 15-year-old list that his wife had made for him for honeydews, too.
I hear you. At the 19, first and 10 Gators, leading 10-7 over Lakeside Evans. Bailey in motion, hand off to Tobler. He just tries to sidestep up the middle for a couple. Once again, downstairs to Scott.
Yeah, that was hard hitting. He may have got a yard right there. This team's starting to impress me here. We really got to make some big adjustments here. The Panthers are going to walk on us if we don't adjust out to this.
Gain to the 21-yard line. It is second down and nine. A short nine, but we're only up by three. Trips up top on the left as we go left to right. Now we move Bailey instead to the right. By himself, Johnson, snap.
There we go.
Complete. And driving on a little hitch up to the 30 and gets pushed back as Josh Johnson on the reception. So Josh getting in on a little action.
And now we've run off almost a minute off of the clock, but so we got to be at least mindful of the time, although we have all of our timeouts remaining.
2:18 remaining in the half, 10-7 Ware leading. We're slow up to the line to change move on that last carry or last pass play by Johnson to Johnson from the 30. Snap, Jamar, quick out. Issa right on him. Tackle made by number 17, Robbie Bishop. Gain of maybe two, three.
And we've talked about it all year. This is a good coaching staff at Lakeside that has seen our film and says, guys, you guys seem to be a little one-dimensional. You run the ball a whole bunch. So we're going to see if you can pass the ball. And so far, we're not as comfortable as we are running the ball, but certainly Jamar has stepped up to the assignment pretty well.
Second down 8 at the 32. 10-7, Ware leading late in a half here. 92 seconds, clock running over Lakeside Evans. We with the ball there. Back to pass. Jamar has time. Fires it out low on the left, and a diving catch by Dudley up around the 37 will make it at least more of a palatable situation.
And we took a timeout, I believe, Brian.
Timeout, Gators. A minute 18 left in the half. 10-7, Ware leading. 30-second break, and you're listening to Gator football.
J. Green & Company Jewelers has the largest selection of diamonds from Jacksonville to Atlanta. Come see our largest selection of diamond bridal ever. J. Green & Company Jewelers, Waycross, Kingsland, Brunswick, and now Douglas.
Throw it back the other way. And back at Memorial Stadium, where the Gators have called a timeout. And, Clay, we knew it was going to be a tougher game than what a lot of the state thought it would be, because these guys, like I mentioned to Coach Dudley on Coach's Corner, it's a... They play in a tough region. They have a tough strength of schedule ranking. They have a higher strength of schedule ranking than we do. Of course, I mean, that's nothing on our end, any fault. That's just the way it worked out. But so third down, 4. Now the 37 aware. From the gun, Jamar, low snap, rolls right, looks, has time. They're going to rush him. He throws dangerously, I think, incomplete. Oh, my, into some traffic looking for Isolo right around the right hash, fell innocently to the ground, but a lot of white jerseys there.
So we've got a punt here now. There's really no other option with a minute and 12 seconds left, and now you just hope to get to halftime with a three-point lead.
Bennett comes in to punt, and they put Raymond back deep around their 25 or so. Now let's see if John can boom one here. Quick snap to him, and he boots it. Left footer is going to be low. Line drive, spinning top is going to get the job done, though, and go out of bounds around the 31-yard line. So Lakeside Evans will begin first and 10 at their own 31-yard line, trailing only 10-7. They did a very impressive drive on us just a few minutes ago with their passing game and running game, actually. So let's see what they do here with trips on the left. From the gun, their quarterback is Hunter Banks, a junior. Referees holding things up. Tobler's looking to the sideline for something. At the 31, play action, swing pass incomplete. Trying to hit Edwards out here on the left side. We had Tobler closing in on him. That stops the clock with a minute 1 remaining down the half.
That inside receiver again just running a swing pass all the way out to the sideline. And our linebacker, Tobler, is having to come all the way over to defend that. We've got to find a different solution.
At the 31, second and 10. Banks, pump fake, long, right side, goes up, incomplete. Raymond, the intended receiver, Gibson was trying to go up for some sort of an INT, but it fell incomplete.
And Gibson didn't bite on that at all. He's been so consistent all year long, has Gibson, and that's just one that even on the fake punt, his head never even swiveled.
Well, now are you in jeopardy of them giving us back the ball?
You certainly are. That's why you might see a run play here to at least make us burn a timeout.
Third and 10, 56 seconds left in the half, 10-7 Ware leading, Lakeside with the ball for now. True spread, empty backfield for Banks. Now he resets. And we got a penalty marker thrown. Omar saw that from up here.
Maybe backfield.
Yeah, illegal procedure. They were trying to get Jones set back there with him, but somebody else moved while he was shifting, and that's going to cost them 5 back to the 26. Clock did not move, so it's now 3rd and 15. And they're on 26-yard line. The receivers out here on the left talking to each other. They stack twins on each side. From the 26. Banks looks, throws over the middle. He's got a man wide open, 40, 45. He's trying to evade us. He is midfield. And we finally drive him out down around the 42 of Ware with 46 seconds left. Edwards is really showing his stuff tonight.
And what he did was a delay pass there. He let his other receivers run upfield, and we got in position for them. And he left about a second and a half after them. And there was just, he had a whole lane in which nobody was really there to defend him.
When do you start bringing the house? At the 42. 46 seconds left. First and 10. Lakeside on the move. Pump fake again. Here we go with the rusher. We get him at the 46.
Layoff.
Montre Merritt. He almost slipped through that. Loss of three. It could have been much worse. Timeout Lakeside-Evans with 39 seconds left at the 45 of Ware. When time resumes, it'll be second down and about 13, maybe 14. 30-second timeout. Ware County leading 10-7, and you're listening to Gator football.
Southeast Mower and Saw Shop is your dealer for Husqvarna, the world leader in outdoor power products for forestry and lawn and garden care. See their modern showroom on the Brunswick Highway, where you'll find a large selection of lawn tractors and the popular zero-turn mowers. They also have other Husqvarna products like blowers, chainsaws, hedge trimmers, pole saws, and much more. Southeast Mower, your Waycross Husqvarna dealer and proud supporter of high school sports.
Lakeside Evans has it second down. 14 is what we'll call it, with 39 seconds remaining at the 45 of Ware. 10-7, Gators leading. From the gun, Banks back to pass. Here we come again. Throws a screen underneath. Incomplete. Intended for Jones. Tobler was right there tackling him, but it was thrown just too high. Of course, we had the rush. They let it in on the screen pass, but still, I think Banks might have felt a little bit rushed to throw it that high.
Montre Merritt, he was in on that play right then. He's putting some pressure on.
Stops the clock with 34.7, and we have one of these basketball shot clocks here. Remaining in the half, 10-7, and they take their final timeout.
Now, that's a little strange because that makes it difficult for them to make a field goal.
I'll say that. Maybe that's their second timeout.
Did y'all see that, Brian, where Cat Jenkins lined up that time? Defensive end?
Yeah. Well, we're having to try some sub. You got to put some pressure. You know, when he has picked us apart, especially this pass where he was so much on the money, he had time.
That's
yeah,
right.
He
had time, and that kind of reminds me of, here we go again. Omar's gotten us into comparing college and high school like crazy. But the Texas A&M quarterback, you know, I was saying all along, if he's killing you anyway, don't drop back in coverage. Bring the house. And when they did on the last series, they got to it. But
Brian, does this remind you about us game? The quarterbacks just telegraphing everything he's doing.
Yeah, he's got five receivers to do it here. It is third down, 14 at the 45 of Ware. True spread. Banks back to pass. We're rushing him. We're going to grab him and sack him at the 44 of Lakeside Evans. Cat Jenkins.
There you go. Off of that defensive end, too.
Wonder why we don't take a timeout here and at least put ourselves in position to go for the punt.
Apparently not. We're letting the clock run. They're going to say he's actually forward progress to his own 46.
Jones,
so loss of nine.
Jones 7, Glen Academy 7 at halftime.
Wow. Well, this is a very close game as well. It's going to be 10-7. Oh, they're calling their final timeout. Look at this. They've let the clock wind down to 2 points. Was that 2.0 seconds?
Yeah.
10-7, and they have called their final timeout. Interesting.
And what happens there is they're saying, Ware County, if you don't use yours, then you're allowing us to make a Hail Mary throw.
True.
If we would have used ours back at 22 seconds, then they can't make the Hail Mary throw. So that's why I like burning our timeout. Even if we go into victory formation, it prevents them from making this Hail Mary throw.
I got you.
But he better have a cannon to throw it.
Yeah, he'll have to launch it, 65 yards?
55 yards, that's right. At a minimum.
I'm thinking where he's going to go back to.
Yeah, that's right. he needs the Doug Flutie running start.
The spot, the 46-yard line.
Head game's going on here, guys.
Yeah, well, you pretty much know what they're going to try. Anything short of that, you can come in on, but... Okay, Banks stands at his own 40. From the 46, 2 seconds left in the half. Back to pass. Looks long down the left side, but we go.
Intercept
it at our 25-yard line. And that is Mills,
man,
on the INT, but the half's going to end there.
Try to get us with the wheel route out of the backfield.
So we've completed one half of play. Your score, Ware 10. Lakeside Evans 7, 3 minute timeout. You're listening to Gator football.
Start living the skiff life today.
Hey,
efficient hull designs, you'll get more fun for your money for years to come. See your Carolina Skiff dealer today or visit carolinaskiff.com for more information. Go anywhere, do anything in a Carolina Skiff.
Carolina Skiff LLC, proud sponsors of Gator football.
Thinking about redecorating? Lee Hardware says maybe changing up your wall color, even on the outside? Create ambiance you can't wait to come home to with rich, beautiful colors from Valspar Medallion Premium Interior and Exterior Paints. They're available at Lee Hardware and Building Supply in Waycross. Lee Hardware is a family-owned business. They feature a complete selection of lumber, millwork, and related building materials. And, of course, famous Valspar paint. Lee Hardware says, go Gators!
It's in the air, but does it have the distance? Yes, it's gone!
What a great game for the Ware County Gators, and a great time for you to purchase a new vehicle from Crosby, Nissan, GMC, and Cadillac. Don't pass up your chance to save thousands of dollars with low interest rates and great rebates on select models.
And the Ware County Board of Education, we proudly present the 2012 edition of the Ware County High School Golden Gator Band. Tonight, the band will be performing selections from Disney blockbuster Pirates of the Caribbean. The Golden Gator Band is led by drum majors Madison Fields and Denzel Washington. Now, the pride of the Swampland, the Golden Gator Band.
Yeah. bring you.
Thank you.
The band officers this year are band captain Will Smith, band co-captain Allison Herndon, secretary treasurer Julie Jernigan, general officer Samantha Strickland, loading crew officer Bruce Talbot, guard captain Kelly Harris, and flag captain Ray Kevin, and soldiers, band chaplain David Carter, band chaplain Tom, chief band officer, Brooke Kyle, assistant with Megan Newton, commodore, generous contributions for helping the Golden Gator Band have a successful year.
Thank you. sir.
Back at Memorial Stadium, Scott Tenner had the coach. We're ready to go. Scott, you still have the coach?
Yeah, I'm fixing to find him right now. A couple adjustments that we did like, he's going to stick with after this. But I'm going to try and run him down. He's trying to fire up the offensive line right now. And just down to getting these last two quarters, time to get ready. All right, coach. Tell us about the first half there.
Well, you know, it's a good first half. We got the turnover. We got the short score right there, so we're up 10-7. You know, Lakeside's brought a good team in here. We tried to sell the kids on that all week and played a little lethargic in the first half. So we have really got to come out and play this half.
All right. Our seniors need to step up and show a little leadership and get these guys loosened up this second half, right?
Yeah, you know, I think we might have been playing a little uptight. I think they're going to be all right. We need to get a drive going. Offense needs to kick in.
All right. Appreciate it, Coach. Go Gators.
Go Gators.
All right, thank you, Scott Tanner, with Coach Ed Dudley. Also, thank you, Ray Williamson, throwing that tape in of Xavier Tobler from post-game last week on senior night that interview ran in this week's Southern Sports Edition magazine that is free of charge. You can pick it up all over town and see the write-up, that and other sports, not just high school, but also college and pro, and not just football, other sports as well. Southern Sports Edition magazine. We're going to be getting the second half kickoff here. We're leading 10-7, I should say. And we're going to be defending the goal to our right as Lakeside comes out.
It's Camden 14, Hillgrove 10, so a little closer game there as well.
Wow. Close games all across the region. We put Isolo back deep. Ellis to kick off for Lakeside Evans. We're up 10-7. It's been a hard-fought game. We were led at one time 10-0.
Lowndes 3, Marietta 16.
He tees it up towards that left hash as the Panthers go left to right this third quarter.
Bainbridge 7, Union Grove 7 halftime.
Oh, and it's a sky kick, and it's a good one. We're going to fair catch it, yeah. Down at the 27, Porter does a wise thing, maybe the 28-yard line. Did one of those little bloop kicks that the kicking team tries to run over, since it's a run under, I should say, since it's a live ball, and Porter called the fair catch, went down with it at the 27 aware. Thing about it, Clay, and that kind of neutralizes any return. But at the same time, you just want to get the possession of it.
And I like Porter immediately calling for the fair catch, and two of his players coming up around him just in case there was a fumble. They were there to help.
At the 27, we go to the gun immediately. Tobler in the backfield with Jamar Johnson, first and 10. Snap to him, handoff Tobler, straight up the gut, twists down at the 31-yard line, giving four.
And I think Coach Dudley would hit it, the nail on the head, when he talked about us being a bit lethargic in the first half. And I think he seemed very confident that we were going to come out with a little additional fire. The question becomes, what do we do with our safety when we come back on defense? But right now, let's see if we can put together an offensive drive.
Second down and 6 from the left hash. Jamar again, a little bit of a hurry up. Keeps it after faking the Tobler. They read it and they grab him by the ankles. Good tackle out there. One of the Panthers coming up was Daniel Cotty, a junior linebacker. Grabbed Jamar by the ankle. Only got a yard or two. Brings up third down and 4.
Yeah, and he was just, if that tackle would not have occurred, I mean, as he was falling, he just swiped his hand and hit his feet and ankles. Jamar would have had the first down.
Ball across the 33-yard line. We started at the 27. Third and a short 4, 10-7, Ware leading. First offensive series of the second half. From the gun, back to pass. Jamar looks, fires underneath, too low, incomplete. Just missed Tobler out in the flat on the right side. Took a little off of it, but he took too much off of it, threw it at his feet.
Yeah, he didn't throw that ball with a lot of confidence, you know, and it didn't release from his hand very well.
So Ware goes 3 and out. We're going to have to give it back to these guys, and they really rammed it down our throats right before the half. Raymond back deep, standing at his 30. Bennick stands at his 22. Left footer boots it away from the receiver. Going to go bounce sideways at the 37, 38-yard line of Lakeside Evans. Great field position. Let's send it down to Scott.
Yeah, we need to change channels right fast. Like, we got a bunch of new jerseys in there, and we're going to try something different right here. Look at this, Brian. You got Mills. We may see him on offense, but right now he's been the big play man on defense, him and McBride have. Let's see what kind of pressure they put on here.
At the 37, trips on the right from the pistol. Banks, handoff to the tail, and he just runs into a clog of green. Gets absolutely nothing. You'll be lucky to get back to the line.
That's right, Clay. That's, you know, that's what we got to do. We got to clog that running game, and they're telegraphing the passing game, so we can pick them apart right here if we just be patient.
At the 37 and a half, give him a half a yard. Back to pass. Banks has time on an underneath route, tipped in the air, incomplete. Well defended by Porter. Intended for Raymond coming underneath around the 40. It tipped up high. We didn't have any green jerseys in the area to get to it in time. Bell incomplete, brings up third, 9 and a half.
So the question in the second half is, what do we do with our safeties? In other words, we were leaving our safety back, and they were burning us with those. They were going horizontal, not vertical on us.
At the 38, third, 9 and a half. Hard count, no jump. Banks looks to the sideline as if to say, hey, it didn't work, coach. Now we get the Gator crowd over here on the home side chanting defense. Banks from the gun, third, 9 and a half. And he drops the ball, fumble at the 32. He may have gotten back on it. He did a little fake, but when he did it to Edwards, or Jones rather, it fell on the ground, and luckily for Lakeside Evans, they got back on it.
Both quarterbacks coming out in the second half a little bit gun-shy, so let's see if they'll settle down.
So fourth down, loss of four. 10-7 Ware leading. They're having to give us back the ball. Punter. They want a penalty out here. And he shanks it off the side of his foot. He hurried it up to avoid any penalty, and it's going to be shy midfield.
Yeah, that's great field position. It was not even really past, much past their first down marker. So let's see if we can capitalize here and get some points on the board. But we've got to come out with some energy. We've got to come out with some energy here.
So Tanner Duran just shanked it. They're going to give him credit up to midfield. And that is it. So about a 17-yard punt for the young man. Gators, excellent field position. Low in motion, first and 10. Jamar under center. Play action, rolls right. Looks, here comes the rush. Can he get away? He's got three, four, and goes down there. He's lucky to get that.
Yeah, and he's got to protect that ball, too, when he's getting out of traffic. He held it out to the side, and I'm 100 yards from him, and I could see the whole football as he was maneuvering through that crowd.
Micah Johnson came in from behind to get his ankles. At the 46, not quite the 46, brings up second down along six, 10-7. Ware leading Lakeside Evans, 8:44 left, third period action at Waycross's Memorial Stadium. Now Jamar goes to more of a pistol formation. They show blitz, handoff. We tiptoe up and then get down. I'm not sure yet. We got a little penetration to the 46 inside of it. So only a gain of a foot or two. Brings up third down and six.
I wonder if that screen pass, the famous Richmond Hill screen pass, is going to be available to us this evening, where we kind of roll one way and then we throw back the other way. I would like to see us try that at some point in time.
You almost feel like there's a bait going on here. At the 46, from the gun, Bailey in motion. Jamar Johnson back to pass, looks, pump fakes, goes long down the right side. Lines got an incomplete,
yeah, he's got,
and flags come down all over the place. Intended for Isolo. There's some early contact. I think that Robbie Bishop's going to be called for it, the senior. Flags really flew. Isa had a step or two on him.
Yeah, he did really the only thing. The coach will tell him, you did the right thing. He reached out, just grabbed his jersey. If he didn't do that, that was going to be 6 points. And, yes, you are penalized, but that's better than 6 points.
Beautiful thrown pass. Right on the money. Interference call coming against Lakeside Evans.
He really bit on the pump. And I think that's what caused it.
Again, downstairs to the sidelines with Scott.
Yeah, that was another fist fight for the balls. It was a lot of contact between both of them, but Bo Carter had it on here where earlier play that, you know, they were pulling us down by the shoulder pads before the ball even got to us, and they just got caught that time.
all the way down to the 30-yard line. Actually, more of a 16-yard penalty, if you will.
Might be what we needed here, Brian.
Chains move, first and 10 Ware. We're up 10-7, beginning to get midway in the third period, and we're on the move. They're slow getting the chains moved now. They're going to have to...
I think a timeout.
Okay.
Lakeside,
right? Well, the ref is going over to the coach to talk things over. Timeout on the field, 10-7, Ware leading, 30-second break, and you're listening to Gator football.
Introducing HD Made Easy, only for MediaStream. HD channels are now included with your MediaStream Essential Value Cable Service. Enjoy dozens of channels in HD. No need for a cable box. Simply scan the channels with your HD television and uncover a wide selection of the best channels in high definition. No extra equipment, no extra remote, no extra charge, no early termination fee. MediaStream is bringing it home to you.
Call 283-2332 for details. 283-2332.
Bringing it home to you.
Stream. Back at Memorial Stadium in Waycross, it's 10-7. Ware leading Lakeside-Evans. The Panthers have just burned a timeout after an interference penalty call that really was not even close as to whether or not it occurred or not. So now we're set to go. First and 10. They were slow getting the chains set. And we're at the 30 of the Panthers. Dudley comes off the line and goes in motion. Under center, Jamar takes the snap. Tobler just looking for blocking. There's none. Oh, they really penetrated. 51 in there is Devontae Yeomans. 44 as well as Brad Sankey, a defensive end. Both of them seniors. No gain. Second and 10.
Yeah, when you watch green helmets on silver helmets, unfortunately, silver helmets are not moving backwards. It's somewhat neutralized, but neutralized doesn't quite work in the running game. This team is asking Ware County, can you throw the ball on us?
Well, we've certainly put it up.
And we've been somewhat successful with it.
And then we go to the gun here, and we're going to call timeout, I think. Oh, timeout Lakeside again?
No, that was on us.
Okay, now he goes the right direction. All right. We've had this problem this year with officials indicating the wrong way against each other. Timeout Ware County on second and 10 at the 30. 30-second break and station identification, and you're listening to Gator football.
Turn your old silver coins, gold coins, and silver flatware to cash today at J. Green & Company Jewelers. We pay cash on the spot. All transactions confidential. J. Green & Company Jewelers, Waycross, Kingsland, Brunswick, and Douglas.
WKUB, Blackshear, Waycross.
At Waters Ford, we'll always take care of you. Oh, yeah.
The Ware County Gator stream team is up and running. Taping this, we'll archive it on the website, ghsa.tv/Ware County, probably around midnight tonight. Brought to you by Robbie Robertson Ford and Tyndall Enterprises through the auspices of the Ware County Touchdown Club. Channel 42, City of Waycross, is channel on MediaStream, also will air it. Second down, Jamar keeps it. Little read around the right side. He bounces outside, 25 and down there, maybe 24. Let's see, they're going to back him up to the 25. So gain of solid 5 on that carry by Jamar.
They have team speed. I can't think of anyone in our region, if we ran that play, that doesn't produce a first round. This team does have a bit of Lakeside.
They
have closing speed on the corners.
They certainly do. So it's now 3rd and 5, or actually shorter than 5, but not by much. 10-7, Ware leading midway in this third period, and we're at the 25 of the Panthers. Snap, handoff. This is looking for some block by Tobler. They ride him down after only a yard. Again, that number 9, Daniel Cotty, a junior linebacker, coming up to make the tackle on Tobler from behind. We're going to bring on the field goal unit.
And so this is in that arena that is makeable for us, but at the same time, it is a long poke for
it
Seth Starling.
That's right. It's not a chip shot, in other words. He is going to make the try, set down at the 32, so a 42-yard attempt from the left hash. Falk to hold and Starling to try. Good snap and set. Boot is up.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, got it. Yeah.
Plenty of room to spare.
So with 5:36 left in the third, it's now 13-7. Ware leading Lakeside-Evans. 30-second timeout. You're listening to Gator football.
Dixie Chopper is the world's fastest commercial mower and leader in price, performance, and durability. Guaranteed. Let me repeat that. Dixie Chopper is the world's fastest commercial mower and leader in price, performance, and durability. Guaranteed. Oh, others claim to be fast, but there's only one Dixie Chopper. The choice is yours. You can spend your money-making time, or you can spend your money-making money. Dixie Chopper, the world's fastest commercial mower. See them today at Southeast Mower and Saw Shop, 2294 Brunswick Highway, Waycross, behind the mall. Or visit us at DixieChopper.com.
Back at Memorial Stadium, Brian Blunt, Clay Thomas, Omar Oliver in the box, Scott Tanner on the sidelines. We are now up 13-7, and we're kicking off. Starling does that as well. And the D's going to have to rise to the occasion again. He boots it. This is longer.
Oh, yeah.
Short at the 2, taken to the 5-10. Raymond stops, gets down short of the 20, down at the 18-yard line.
That's a special teams win anytime you hold them with inside of that 20-yard line. So a little height on that ball to help them get the time to get down the field. So special teams has been a plus for us tonight. Good job, Seth Starling.
Check that Howell's, rather, on the return up to the 19-yard line. First and 10 Lakeside, but we're up 13-7 now. They've shown they can drive it on us. True spread. Banks, your quarterback from the 19. Looks left. Fires, swings it out to Edwards. Looking for some blocking. He's got it. 20, 25, 26, and we hit him there. Gibson coming up.
And Brian, people at home that are listening, you often hear people say they have a vertical passing game. These guys don't. They have a horizontal passing game,
yeah.
Which, in other words, they throw to the flats. They spread it out and throw to the flats.
But the blocking gets them downfield.
Yeah, wide receiver blocking.
Gain of 7, 2nd and 3. True spread again. Banks looking right, same play. And it's complete to Raymond. And this time, flags go down, and we key on him and stop him, and Sogler throws him for a loss. Watch a penalty here.
I'm thinking and hoping that's a holding. And Tobler's gimpy, though. He's hurt.
Got his foot stepped on.
Tobler comes off. Merritt comes on. They're talking the penalty over. Marking it off against Lakeside Evans. It's a hold. The play was for a loss. We're going to take the penalty, though.
So now what we have to be careful of is now we're focused on that horizontal throwing game, and so we have to be careful that we don't leave the vertical lane open right down the middle of the field because we've shifted our safeties over. So in the center of the field, we don't have any help.
2nd and 13 at the 15. 13-7, we're leading. We're showing blitz. Back to pass. Here we come. Banks is going to get sacked.
The ball on the ground. Fumble. And they're going to jump on it. It's still on the ground. Fumble. We jump on it.
Touchdown.
Touchdown.
Number 22, Montre Merritt. Oh, man.
Was that wild or what? The ball just kept going backwards. They would jump on it. It was still live. We were trying to get it and wound up in the end zone, and Merritt winds up with it in the end zone.
One of their big offensive linemen fell on top of the ball at about the 1, but we made contact with him the same time he jumped on the ball, and that ball just flew back in the air again. It was a melee there for a while. And forgive my lack of professionalism. I'm never supposed to holler during your call.
No, that's fine.
I became a spectator for a moment. Forgive me.
I think we all were.
Yeah.
I think Scott's the one that told us Montre Merritt, wasn't
he? Yeah.
So point after attempt is forthcoming here. Wow. The defense is swarming again tonight. Nice snap. Good set. It's up. And it's good. 20-7 on a fumble recovery in the end zone off of a blitz that just really, really shook Banks out of his shoes. 30-second timeout. Gators leading, and you're listening to Gator football.
Start living the skiff life today with America's number one selling boat brand, Carolina Skiff. Affordable, durable, and versatile, our full line of all-purpose, all-composite boats will keep you focused on enjoying your time on the water. And with Carolina Skiff's fuel-efficient hull designs, you'll get more fun for your money for years to come. See your Carolina Skiff dealer today or visit carolinaskiff.com for more information. Go anywhere. Do anything in a Carolina Skiff.
Carolina Skiff LLC, proud sponsors of Gator football.
Ryan, Central Carroll 13, Pierce 6, Ryan.
And here it is 20-7, Ware leading. Man, we brought the house. I begged them to do that earlier tonight. We've been doing it since then. And look at that. The boot by Starling taken by Hauser at the 5-10 going to the left side, cutting across. 15. Ooh, oh, ooh. Porter comes up and nearly de-cleats Hauser. How's about that?
He was being chased by Mills, and he ran into Mr. Porter. And once again, it was one of those where the whole crowd screams, whoo. And that makes me feel good when I hear that.
At the 14-yard line, first and 10. Panthers now the biggest deficit of the game by 13 points. They're down. But don't think they can't come back. They've driven it down us earlier on the night. At the 14. Banks looks the D over, stacked twins on both sides. Banks looks left. Pump fake, goes down the left sideline. Way incomplete, had it defended back there, and Gibson's going to get called. They're going to call interference. Actually, we were in pretty good position. Cat Jenkins coming over, but apparently, I think maybe as he was running, he reached an arm out, and that might have been what cost him.
Well, Brian, you're very tactful. About what I would like to say is I have no idea what that official saw.
Well, that's the only thing I saw. His arm came out, and I don't know that it made contact because I don't have the right trajectory from here. Either way, no need to argue because they're marking it off 15 yards up to the 29-yard line.
It's fun to argue.
Sure it is.
It's fun to argue.
I can't argue with that.
Yeah.
At the 29, first and 10. From the gun, trips on the right, this formation on this play. Banks just hands off to a running back who breaks a tackle or two. Oh, man, he goes down hard after three or four. Jalen Harrison, the sophomore, got up to the 32. But Lord, when he hit the ground, I was afraid his head hit that turf hard because one of our guys came in right behind the initial tackler. Gain is almost to the 33, second down, 6.5. It's 20-7, Ware leading. Back to pass, Lakeside-Evans. Lynn, we're going to penetrate again and sack Banks back at the 28-yard line. He wanted to do another one of those pump fakes. He did that and send Forrest Nanny up the right sideline, but something happened. I don't know if that was a miscommunication. He basically had to eat it, and by the time he decided he was in trouble, there were all kinds of green jerseys.
He fake pumped into number 98's eyeballs, which is Jamal McBride, and Jamal didn't take too kindly to that.
Third down, 10.5 at the 28-yard line. 20-7, Ware leading Lakeside-Evans here for round one of GHSA playoff action in Waycross. Banks, a little draw handoff around that left side, and down he goes after a gain up to the 34-yard line is Harrison.
And that's what we did on that play. We dropped everybody back to keep that play in front of us to put them in a fourth down. And we were willing to give up that 6 or 7 yards to make them punt the ball.
Wilkins and Mills coming up to make the stop around the 34. So a punt situation. Let's punt it down to Scott on the sidelines.
Man, that's cool. I tell you what, we made the right adjustments. Me and Joe and Bo were just talking about a while ago. And I'm sorry about treading on y'all's licks over there a while ago, but 22 was awesome on that play.
I don't think I could see who it was. There were so many. High snap to the punter. We penetrate, and he gets it off there.
Poison.
And it takes a great roll for Lakeside-Evans. Look at that, all the way down inside our 25. We brought the house on the punt.
Yeah, 20-yard punt with a 15-yard roll or better. So.
Don't forget about the Tommy Palmer scoreboard coming your way at 10 o'clock or at the conclusion of this game, whichever is later. Last word, Central Carroll is up on Pierce 13-6. You had something about Glenn Academy and Jones. They were
tied at halftime. Fitzgerald from the Robert Gaddis Sports Information Bureau. Fitzgerald 21, Northeast Macon 13.
Wow. Here it's 20-7. Ware leading. We're at our own 24-yard line, but we're back on offense. Under center now. Jamar's just going to hand off. They key on Tobler. Look, the guy just leans in for a couple, knowing that they're looking for him. You know, when Tobler told me last week on the interview that he'd rather be the hitter than the hitty, I started to say, look, when you're a running back, you're the hitter.
Yeah. I wouldn't want to tackle him. I can tell you that.
Gain of 2, second down. We're actually close to the 27, so we started closer to the 25. Second and 8. Bailey in motion. Three receivers, four receivers now. Low snap. Hand off to Tobler. He steps through. Can't break the second tackle up around the 32, but again, good yardage.
In Tobler, that's kind of interesting. He tried to break it outside to pick up the big yards where he would have had a little more inside, and their speed even closed on Tobler. This is a pretty quick team that we're playing against.
Alza on the tackle up to the 32, brings up third down, a more manageable 3.5. We're up by 13 with a minute 18 clock running third period.
Glen Academy 10, Jones County 7.
I knew that was going to be a good game. Add the 32. From the gun. Johnson crouches down, hands off to Mills, coming around left to right. Can't quite get a block, but breaks a tackle, 35-40. And they finally get him. They're trying to strip him down around the 45. And he goes down finally. He had to hang on for dear life. I didn't think he got a block. Somebody threw one right at the last second to create a seam. Diedrich found his way through it and got up to the 46-yard line.
But you're right. It was doomed at beginning, and somebody out of somewhere just made a block for him to open him up, and then he used his natural talent to get down the field. And if there are any college coaches listening to us, which I highly doubt that, somebody please come look at Diedrich Mills.
And he's just a freshman. At the 46. First and goal, chains move. 20-7, Ware leading Lakeside-Evans. Again, crouch down low. Jamar fakes it to Diedrich. Oh, it's Tobler, rather, from the Wildcat up to midfield. So we're running out of the Wildcat in the last couple of plays with Tobler. Man got across midfield. Now we're looking for the play. Jamar Johnson back in at quarterback.
I'd let it run to the fourth quarter. I wouldn't call a play.
Yeah, we're under 10 seconds. Second down, 6.
Yeah, the coaches are pointing to the scoreboard.
And that's exactly what happens. We've completed 3 here tonight. 20-7, Ware leading Lakeside-Evans. 30-second break, and you're listening to Gator football.
Thinking about redecorating? Lee Hardware says maybe changing up your wall color, even on the outside? Create ambiance you can't wait to come home to with rich, beautiful colors from Valspar Medallion Premium Interior and Exterior Paints. They're available at Lee Hardware and Building Supply in Waycross. Lee Hardware is a family-owned business. They feature a complete selection of lumber, millwork, and related building materials. And, of course, famous Valspar paint. Lee Hardware says, go Gators!
Back at Memorial Stadium, let's send it to the sidelines with Scott.
Well, we got the crowd behind us now. We were kind of quiet for a little while there, but we made the right adjustments to just give me a heart attack along with Omar. Brian, he's the ever game pessimist, so he just knew what was fixing to go on. But look at the new numbers right here. Now we're going to bring Jenkins up. Yep.
We swapped sides of the field. Didn't have far to go since the nose of the ball is right at midfield. Second down, 6. We go left to right this final period, leading 20-7, Ware over Lakeside-Evans. Jamar Johnson from the gun. Low snap to him.
Here you go.
On a little, what appeared to be supposedly a slant route. Then he threw it to his outside shoulder, incomplete. Ice a low. Number 2 coming over, Tanner Brassel on the defense.
Now I'm going to drive you guys crazy with my Clay Thomas time management math. If we do not score on this drive, yet we run 3 to 4 minutes off the clock, that is still a victory.
But we have 3rd and 6 here.
We're going to do it.
Well, you know.
I don't know. We're just now getting our personnel out of the field.
Richmond Hill, you said that. And you were right.
Yeah.
Tobler late coming in as Bolds comes out. We go to the gun from this, 3rd and 6 at midfield. Back to pass. We look like we're going to throw a screen, and we do. Complete to Tobler on the left flat instead. Up to the 45 and a first down around the 41. And you were right.
We're going to do it, Brian. And we're going to run 3 to 4 minutes off this clock.
Don't forget that you can watch the City of Waycross's Channel 42 tomorrow morning at 10 for a replay of this game. And then they run it again at 3 and again at 7 on Saturday. And there's a schedule throughout the course of the week I'll touch on in just a few minutes. At the 41, chains move. 1st and 10 Ware from the pistol. Jamar, options. Late pitch and the ball's fumbled, and they're going to pick it up and jump on it at their own 47-yard line. Oh, my. Number two recovering, Tanner Brassel. Now it's our turn to turn it over.
If you remember in the Richmond Hill game, Tobler fumbled, and then he came back on the field like a man possessed.
He really did.
I'm going to try to put a positive spin on this thing.
So on the pitch, the fumble down at the 47. Now the D is going to have to rise. They're leading 20-7, but these guys can come down on you in a hurry. Four receivers, one setback. Banks from the gun. Puts Edwards in motion. We're actually back with him. Fakes it to him. Fakes it to the other back. Rolls right. Dinks it out underneath. Complete at midfield. Cuts back 45 and down at the 40. And we get him there. Ely coming up. Causer. But look at the gain all the way down inside our 40-yard line.
Yeah, and just another kind of formation, another wrinkle that they're throwing at us that we've got to be able to make adjustments for. Glenn Academy pulling away 17-7.
Call it the 40. First down, change move. Play action, roll, left, complete. That is to Edwards, and he jumps out. Well, I thought he was stepping out. Finally, at the 30, gain of 10, that might be a first down.
And once again, the same swing pass to that inside receiver. And that number five, I don't know how many times he's caught that play, and it's been effective every time they have done it.
He's a good receiver.
And they block up field as well as any high school football team I've ever seen.
Chains move, gain of 10.5.
The receivers do.
They're inside our 30. 20-7, Ware leading, but here comes the Panthers after the turnover. From the gun, again, that inside cross buck. This time, Tobler wraps him up. McBride almost had him, then the Greenway finishes him off. Very little gain, if any.
I keep looking at that clock, and I think it's just not running fast enough for me.
Jones on the carry. They were doing a little bit of what you see wing T teams do, the inside reverse cross buck. At the 31, loss of a couple, second down, 11. Snap, roll. Banks looks, throws long. We go up incomplete. Oh, Gibson had a better beat on it. Now a flag goes down late.
That was a tip ball. I think what we need to argue as coaches is contact was made after the tip.
I think it was against them. If you see all the hand play that was going on.
Gibson went up and made the contact with the ball long before our other defender hit the receiver.
You're
tip
right.
Ball, okay.
Tip ball, no flag.
Wave the flag off.
Gibson's going to be an attorney one day.
Gibson, he's going to be a cross between an attorney and a coach.
Yeah, he argued his case and won his case.
Sure did.
I like that.
Third down, 11 at the 31 of the Gators, 20-7. Ware leading Lakeside-Evans. Clock stop, 10.5 minutes left in this game. Plenty of time for anything to happen.
But I know Gibson, so I'm going to pick on him for a second. But he also dropped a ball that was right in his hands.
Here we go, double. Twins stacked each side. Snap the Banks. He's looking left. Fires hard. Incomplete. Trying to go down the seam to number 81, McTyre Mosley. He's their tall wide receiver that we thought we'd see a lot more of tonight because he is so tall. He split the coverage, but he led him too far.
They're getting away a little bit from their game of what they did so well. I don't know why they don't go back to that swing pass.
They must feel pressured into time.
Yeah.
But there's plenty of it. They're going for it. Fourth down, 11 at the 31. This is big. Man coverage. Press coverage. Back to pass. Rolling to his right. Banks looks. Throws long in the end zone. We're going to go up and bat it down. Incomplete.
What a play.
Cameron Gibson intended for Edwards, their surefire hands guy. But
what a
Gibson
play.
Batted it down, and that was smart because you don't want to intercept it that far back.
That's a smart play by Cameron Gibson, and that's the biggest play of the game right there. That's the biggest play of the game. That turnover does not hurt us, and we chew up a little bit of time, not much, only about a minute, but that turnover ends up not hurting us.
We come out towards the right hash, going left to right, and the change of possession goes to Ware. 20-7, Gators leading Lakeside-Evans. Plenty of time left in this game. Lakeside's late getting started here on sat on defense, and we're going to center out of the eye. You know they're looking for our tailback here. Play action on a go down the right side. It's underthrown, incomplete, and a flag goes down.
Yeah.
It was underthrown for Isolo. The defender went into Isolo, It could be argued. Now, he's slow getting up. That may be Hauser.
Oh, the ball was underthrown. I think we were going for the jugular there.
Yeah, that was an excellent play. The fake was so good to the tail that they all bought it into Quay Taylor. Pass interference. Their man's still down.
Quite frankly, I bought it. I was looking at the stack of people at the line.
I had to watch Jamar with the ball, and I sat there almost unbelieving that he still had it. So I knew what he was doing, but he just underthrew Isa Lowe. If he would have had him in full stride, he would have been a touchdown for sure. So now they're still dealing with the injured player.
The coach cannot do that. The coach can't come on the field and check on his player and then argue with the official. That's a flag.
Okay.
He can come and check on his player, and that's illegal what he's doing.
I didn't realize that he was doing that. I see him now.
He checked on the player for 2.5 seconds, and then he lit into an official.
All right, they got Hauser up okay. And the only argument he could possibly have was incidental contact because the ball was underthrown. And your man is coming into the receiver with an underthrown ball that Isa has stopped to try to catch.
And I think Dudley just called him out on it, too.
Let's go downstairs to Scott.
Oh, man, all kind of motions out here. That should have been a penalty. Clay's exactly right, or that coach should have called timeout. I don't understand this. It's kind of getting crazy down here.
At the 46-yard line, it's first and 10 Ware. Out of the eye after the penalty on the interference. Man in motion is Isa Lowe. Under center, Jamar. Handoff, Tobler straight up the middle, bounces right, breaks tackle. He's off to the races, to the 30, to the 20, to the 15, and they get him at the 4-5 yard line. Oh, Tobler wanted to score so bad. And one guy, I think maybe Brassel was the one who reached up and got him. Otherwise, he was gone.
And that might be the dagger in the heart. We still have 10 minutes to play, but that certainly changes, that flip-flops the field and puts us in a good position that we need to take care of the football. At worst case scenario, we need 3 points out of this.
At the 5, first and goal Ware. A long run by Tobler of 49 yards. We're on the right hash. Low in motion from the far side. Snap, handoff, Tobler. He just puts his head down and drives to the 4, maybe 3.5.
And let me say again that Mills is coming into the game maybe for some fresh legs because, Tobler just ran the wind sprint of his life. But we need to protect the ball. I would love to have the 6 points, but you've got to have the 3 points to make it a three-score game.
Gain of 2, second and goal at the 3. 20-7, Ware leading Lakeside-Evans. Again, they're slow getting set on defense. We go under center. Snap, handoff. This is Mills juking through and scores in the end zone, walking in.
That's more like it. 26-7. With 9 minutes left in this, the fourth quarter, it looks like Ware County football has started to turn our way.
Uh-oh.
They do have a player down on the field, though.
Yep.
Okay, they, meaning Lakeside-Evans. So credit Mills with a 3-yard touchdown run after a 49-yard run that set that up by Xavier Tobler. They're dealing with number 51, Devontae Yeomans, who has been so good for them tonight.
Checking a stinger. It looks like under his shoulder pad, and then he's cramping right now in the back of his hamstrings. I think he'll be all right.
So Ware County led at the half 10-7.
Yep, he's cramping.
And we're up 26-7 now with a PAT forthcoming.
Another interesting nuance in the game is that Coach Dudley went to check on the player, but the official, and he's done that in every game we've ever played for 4 years now, but the official would not let him. So that was a little interesting.
That is. Of course, it's their call.
Sure.
Falk to hold, Starling to try. 9:02 left in the game. High snap, good set, good kick, whistles blow, so it's going to either be replayed or something. It's got to be. No play. We got a penalty here. Omar hands me Bainbridge 14, Union Grove 7, fourth quarter. Offsides against Lakeside Evans. It'll be marked off on the kickoff is what is indicated.
That was funny. Seth just told him we want to decline it, and he started running off the
field. Yeah, he thought that it was going to be good. He didn't realize the whistle blowing means, no, you got to try again here. So offsides against Lakeside will be marked off on the kickoff, the ensuing kickoff. First off, though, we have to do a repeat performance on the PAT. 26-7, point after pending, Ware leading Lakeside Evans. Good snap and set. Good kick. Make it 27-7. 60 second timeout. You're listening to Gator football.
Community United Federal Credit Union can save you money on a low-rate auto loan, mortgage loan, or personal loan. Whether you're looking for a trendy SUV, a larger home, or a new lawnmower, our low finance rates, low monthly payments, and generous loan amounts can help you with your dream. Plus, we offer a full range of high-yield savings accounts, with all accounts insured up to $250,000 by the NCUA. Visit our office at 1504 Tebow Street or our website at communityunitedfcu.com. An equal opportunity lender.
Back at Memorial Stadium, Brian Blunt, Clay Thomas, Omar Oliver in the sky, Scott Tanner on the sideline. Scott?
All right, guys. Got momentum going right now. No injuries tonight. We're starting to pop a couple of their guys pretty hard, just like the last game. That was a heck of a defensive game. Defense stepped up. And plus, we made adjustments on that swing pass. Now they're going to have to show us a little run to keep us honest now.
I know Mr. Thomas would like to just see some clock burned up. And
yeah, it's driving me crazy, too.
Yeah. Of course, with a passing team, you know, it can be difficult to see that.
Yeah, it's true.
All right, the 5 yards marked off on the kickoff. Starling boots it. This is a low
knuckleball.
Yeah, and it's taken by an up, man. He falls down. He had so much momentum there. I believe that's Harrison. It hit him at the 15. Or maybe that was Hauser.
He ought to get 10 points on that swan dive.
And then he just rebounded off of the way that ball hit him, and he lunged to the 20 and went down.
But the Russian judge gave him an 8.
Trips on the left. First and 10, Lakeside Evans at their own 20, trailing 27-7. Banks, hands off. Oh, and we hit the guy short of the line of scrimmage. The running back, Jones, I believe, didn't stand a chance.
Well, you know, we just talked about that, Brian. You know, they're going to have to go back to the running game to keep us honest out here in the flats.
Loss of a yard. Second and 11 at the 19 of Lakeside Evans. They're late getting personnel in and out. 9 comes in as Cotty Nanny goes out. At the 19, second down. Stacked receivers on the left here. And from the gun, Banks, back to pass, complete. They're going to try to do a halfback pass, and we get him. Tobler comes in and sacks. It was a lateral to number 81, McTyre Mosley. They were trying to do a wide receiver pass, if you will,
yeah,
instead of halfback.
The old double pass.
The old double pass loses 8 more yards.
And our defensive backs just did not bite on it. Did not bite on it.
So it's now third down and 19. 27-7, Ware leading Lakeside Evans. The Panthers really destructing here now midway in this final period. From the 11, from the gun, Edwards in motion. They want to fake it to him, double fake. Banks rolls right, looking for Edwards. They're going to grab him and stack him at the 2-yard line. Stephen Wright on the sack.
And there's an expression that says that there's certain types of offenses that don't work well coming from behind. Theirs is the type of offense, because it is so horizontal and not vertical, they don't come well from behind, and we are capitalizing on it.
At the 2-yard line, they're having to punt. It is fourth down and 29 yards to go. The guy's standing, and he's outside the end line. He better come on back in the field. Tanner Duran to punt. Good snap. Boots it. This is a better punt. Fair catch called for up around the 40-yard line. Wilkins makes the fair catch. So the Gators starting in excellent field position, leading 27-7 midway in this final period. This is round one of GHSA playoff action. 32 teams competing statewide in Class 5A. There will be 16 after tonight. The Gators look like we're going to be right back at home next week. And I've got some information that Beverly Merck has given me to pass along that although school is out next week, reserve seat tickets will be on sale only on Monday. You can get them on Monday. A penalty marker goes down here way back. We have it first and 10. Actually, they spotted the ball at the 36-yard line on that punt reception. Now the Stripes are talking things over on the penalty. Must be a substitution, no. Unsportsmanlike against.
That's just, I think, against Evans. I mean, Lakeside. Correct?
Lakeside, but nothing's marked off, is it? At the 36, first and 10. Not sure what that was. Out of the eye, Jamar Johnson. Play action. He's rolling to his right. He looks like he wants to put it up, and he does. Incomplete. Oh. Intended for Dudley around the 15, 33 rolled in front of him and interrupted, impeded his progression a little. The crowd wanted interference on Rashad Roundtree.
Got a flag on the opposite side of the field over there, Brian.
I think the officials would argue that their feet got tangled
up. Yeah, I think you're right. Intended for Dudley around the 15, and this is a penalty on Ware County. Well, they started marking it off. Now they start again, holding against the Gators. Let me talk about reserve seat tickets. They will be on sale only on Monday at the school in Mrs. Merck's office from 8 till 3. Plenty of time to make it out on Monday. Remember, they're out of school for the Thanksgiving holiday next week, but she will be there Monday for those reserve seat tickets to be sold 8 till 3. Please use the entrance by the gym when entering the building.
It's Camden 28, Hillgrove 10.
So the 46-yard line now, the spot, first and 20. 27-7, Ware leading Lakeside Evans midway in this final period. Iso low in motion, Jamar Johnson play action, back to pass. No, he's handed off, great fake. And that is Davenport on that quick fullback trap up to the 35. Gain of 11, but remember, we needed 20.
That's Brian's favorite play, Clay.
It is, and I love it when it fakes me out because that means it's a good play.
I hear that. Somebody told me Bainbridge up 7 points late in the fourth quarter.
Yeah. That's what Omar had given me over Union Grove. We'll see if that stands up or not. It would be them here next week. It's one of those two teams here next week, provided nothing really crazy happens here. At the 35, it's second down and 9. Again, low in motion. And this time, handoff to Tobler. He just sort of tiptoes through over the center. Gets to the 33, maybe the 32. Give him about 3. And that'll bring up third down.
And let's see, we have North Cobb 35, Valdosta 14. So it looks like Wintersville is going to be without Valdosta playing any further.
The reserve seats, by the way, they go up in price. These prices set by GHSA, $14 next week. General admission, $12. And by the way, general admission tickets can be purchased all week at Kroger, Waycross Bank and Trust, Patterson Bank, and J. Green and Company Jewelers.
Look at the clock, Brian. Looks good, don't it?
5:22 and counting, 27-7 Ware leading Lakeside Evans inside the 33 of the Panthers, 3rd and 7. Dudley flops from left to right on the end. Low in motion from left to right as a wideout. From the eye, the ball's fumbled and they fall on it. Oh, it hit one of the linemen. Jamar Johnson coming back. It hit one of the linemen, his hip or something. He got pushed into the ball. 34, Austin Townsend came up and recovered it at their own 34-yard line. So hold on. We're up by 20, but the Panthers have the ball back. Now our defense really, really came after them last time. Let's see what happens here. At the 34 from the gun, Edwards in motion. You got to watch him. Banks takes the snap. He's looking up the middle. And we bat the ball and they drop it on the carom. Oh, we had a golden opportunity at the 35. Montre Merritt to make his first interception of the year. Somebody got in there and batted it. I don't know if it was Steven Wright or who.
Not only would he have intercepted it, but he would have walked into the end zone. There was nobody even near him. I think he picked up and saw the end zone.
Incomplete pass after all that. We have really gotten penetration on Banks. Now he's coming off the field. I'm not sure what this is. They have a play to run. They're going to run the Wildcat.
With Jones.
Josh Jones from the 34, second and 10. No, it's a different quarterback. Rolling to his right. He's looking, and he just basically throws it at the feet of the intended receiver. Tanner Brassel, the senior, was in at quarterback, intended for Nanny, coming up around the 39, but he just threw it at his feet, incomplete pass.
Now, is this, I assume, just giving some goodwill to the backup quarterback, or this certainly isn't a strategic change? Their quarterback's been very effective.
No, I think Banks is something maybe wrong with him.
Okay, maybe
he went off kind of slowly, like maybe his eyes or something. Okay. I wonder if he got poked in the mask. Third and 10. Back to pass, Brassel has time, fires long down the left. We have three receivers, incomplete, triple coverage on the big tall guy, number 81, McTyre Mosley, and now they're going to be forced to punt. I think it's fourth down, 10, and they're on 35. Yeah, here comes the punt unit, 27-7, Ware leading, 4:45 left in the ball game.
Yeah, I think right here the Gators just get into a safe punt return. We go ahead and let the officials know we're going to be fair catching this ball. Even if you got a mile to run, you fair catch this ball and you start running out that clock.
Punter is Tanner Duran. Stands at his 20, absolutely no rush. Boots it a little bit off the side of his foot again. And it's going to bounce short of the 50-yard line, out of bounds. Only a 13-yard net punt for Lakeside Evans. Again, downstairs to Scott.
Yeah, we got momentum going again. We just keep doing what we're doing, and I'm like Clay, if you manage the clock, we got this game in the bag, I hope.
Chick-fil-A reminds the fans to go by after the game. They'll be open until 11 tonight to satisfy your post-game cravings. Chick-fil-A Memorial Drive across from the mall at Waycross.
And I think we have in our freshman running back now to make sure that Mr. Tobler stays healthy to live another day, to play another day.
Timeout, Lakeside Evans. 4:37 left in the game, 27-7. Ware leading, 30-second break, and station identification, and you're listening to Gator football.
It's in the air, but does it have the distance? Yes, it's good!
What a great game for the Ware County Gators, and a great time for you to purchase a new vehicle from Crosby, Nissan, GMC, and Cadillac. Don't pass up your chance to save thousands of dollars with low interest rates and great rebates on select models all season long. Touchdown! Hustle to Crosby Nissan GMC and Cadillac and register to win Jag tickets. A pair to be given away every home game this season. Crosby Nissan GMC and Cadillac, Memorial Drive, Waycross.
Extra points!
WKUB, Blackshear, Waycross.
At Waters Ford, we'll always take care of you.
Brian, Bainbridge, 14. Union Grove, 13. Fourth quarter.
Oh, boy. Here it's 27-7, Ware leading Lakeside Evans, first and 10 Gators at the 48 of the Panthers. We go under center. You know we're going to run it here. Handoff. And this may be Bolds in getting to the 46. It's not Tobler. Let's see who's on the carry. Yeah, Bolds. Couple of guys coming up to make the stop include Roundtree.
We're bringing in Quay Taylor now.
So gain of a couple, second down and 8. Again, Ware will play the winner of the Bainbridge Union Grove game. Last word, Ray said, Bainbridge 14, Union Grove 13. At the 46, second down 8. And that game will be here next week. Snap, handoff. And this is Taylor, and whistles blow, flags fly, play blown dead. Illegal procedure against Ware. The Ware stream team doing their thing tonight. It's not live streaming because it is a home game, but it will be archived on the website at ghsa.tv/Ware County, probably around midnight or so. Also, Channel 42, City of Waycross's fine channel on Media Stream Cable, will be broadcasting a replay of the game at 10 a.m. in the morning. Of course, you can catch the Cub anytime streaming live audio on the internet.
Yeah, Kenny McCarthy's doing that right this moment.
He is doing that right now.
He is.
Cool. Waycrossradio.com. Hey, Kenny. Okay, the illegal procedure backs us up to midfield, brings up second down and 12. 3:33, clock running, 27-7, Ware leading. Jamar Johnson under center, handoff. Oh, Quay gets hit by one white jersey, and then the rest of them come in and really finish him off after about a yard and a half. And that's 44, one of those linebackers coming in to do that. Brad Sankey, or defensive end, I should say. Gain of a couple, brings up third down and 10. Gators just trying to use up some clock here, and it's running 3:06.
But they also need to emulate a situation with saying, okay, but what if we're playing next week and we're up by 3 points and we need to run out the clock? You know, treat this as a real game situation and practice running out that clock.
Well, and you're up 27-7. It's not like you can't afford to take a chance in the air. I know you don't like if it's incomplete, but at the same time, if you need the yardage. And we go to a pistol. Actually, we're in a very
different
formation, and we get delay a game out of it.
Yeah, I'm not sure that we knew our personnel and formation there.
Yeah, we kind of had our receivers and our backs bunched in more than what I'm used to seeing. So we're backed up across to our 47 now, our own 47. Clock stops on the penalty, 2:38 left in the game. We're set to go with the receivers. Now here comes everybody else. Third down, 14, and our own 47-yard line. Jamar, he's going to run back up the middle. A guy came up and tripped him up, number 9, Daniel Cotty. Johnson just kind of dives close to midfield, and we're going to bring the punt unit on.
Yeah, I would have to put Jamar in a ball cap and the clipboard. He wouldn't be handling any more snaps for me.
He's the up man on the kick.
Oh, I don't like that.
Bennett, which, by the way, that's B-E-N-E-K. We're not saying Bennett, but Bennett. Good snap to him. Left footer boots it.
Wow.
Nice kick. Let's see if it's going to make it out of bounds. Man at the 2-3. He's coming up the sideline. 5-yard line.
Wow, that's pretty.
Gibson was trying to help him spot it, though.
I saw that. So, again, Lakeside-Evans in a hole. Now they're on 5, trailing 27-7, under 2 minutes left in this ball game. Last word, we'll have to get an update from Ray. Central Carroll was over Pierce 13-6 over in Bearville. They got an 8 o'clock start over there. We, of course, 7:30 here. From the gun at the 5, this is the different quarterback. Yeah, Brassel runs to the right, scrambles in the end zone, throws complete out of the end zone to Raymond at the 5-10, breaks a tackle, and gets hit hard at the 12-yard line. And down there, several Gators in on that, I think. So, Cat Jenkins especially.
I know it's late in the game, but really that was a safety. There was holding. That was pretty obvious while he was in the end zone. They just missed it. That can happen.
Backup quarterback is Tanner Brassel, the senior. Gets him out to the 13. Second down and 1. And we key.
Guess who?
McBride and drop him at the 10. Maybe the 11. But when he went backwards, nonetheless, it'll be 3rd and 5. At the 10. 27-7, Ware leading. We're getting down to a minute left in the game. And the Panthers at their own 10. From the gun, Brassel back to pass. Looks long down the right side, throws incomplete. The receiver went down. I think they're going to call this on the offense. He pushed Gibson going down. That was Raymond streaking down the right sideline. The ball was not catchable whatsoever. They're going to say he pushed off, I think. The offense. So let's see.
They're calling
Gators
on us.
Oh, are they? Wow. Well, I totally missed that, being the way that our defender was on this side of him, and he fell towards our defender.
I think I will give you my explanation.
Okay.
It's 27-7.
Oh, yeah, okay. Well, and that's as good as any.
That's my explanation.
Yeah. Well, it gets him out of a hole. It gets him up to the 27-yard line or so. Now they're backing it up to the 25, which is proper, and they were at the 10. So new life, or is it? Yeah, first down at the 25 from the pistol. Back to pass. Brassel looks down underneath. He's got a man coming over and incomplete, threw behind him. intended for the guy we expected to see more of tonight, McTyre Mosley. Up around the 30 or so, and he threw behind him. He had to reach out to try to get it, and stops the clock with 46 and a half seconds left. 27-7, Ware is going to win this thing tonight and host either Bainbridge or Union Grove, the winner of that game. Union Grove with the better record. Bainbridge may very well be the tougher team. At the 25, back to pass again. Underneath again, on a route coming up. Raymond makes the catch, but boy, we're all over him. At the 30 is all he can muster. The green jerseys, Tobler especially in there. Ivy especially, and then about three or four more others. So Brassel doing his best he can. He's down to 25 seconds, the replacement quarterback. From the 30, third down and five, handoff. We weren't expecting this, but we read it well. He only gets about three, and it's going to bring up fourth down. I doubt they're going to get that off, though. We're down to 10 seconds.
Yeah.
So Harrison does the last play of the game on a carry of 3 yards, and the Gators have advanced to round two of GHSA playoff action tonight with a 27-7 victory over Lakeside Evans. 3-minute timeout. We'll wrap it up, and you're listening to Gator football.
Well, your heating and cooling system made it through the hot, hot summer, but is it ready for a cold winter? If you have any doubt, call or stop by Waycross Heating and Cooling. They're located at 1801 State Street, and their phone number is 285-2303. Jeff Wade and his professional technicians can check out and service your unit, and if there's a problem, they can fix it. You're reminded that if you need a new system, we're here to help. Waycross Heating and Cooling is a proud sponsor of Ware County Gator football.
Friends, let's stop spending our weekends driving back and forth from some home improvement warehouse. Let's make one trip to Ace, get help quickly from people who know their stuff, and do it all before our second cup of coffee. Get your weekend back.
Ace can help you quickly turn your to-do list into a to-done list.
Farmers and Builders Ace Hardware in Blackshear. Locations also in Nahanna, Folkston, Kingsland, and St. Mary's. And go Gators!
Ace, the helpful place.
Browning's Medical Arts Pharmacy has a long tradition of excellence in community care. Let registered pharmacist Kenny McCarthy and his staff fill your prescription needs with competency and courtesy. Delivery is just part of our service, and we accept Medicare Part D, State of Georgia, and Medicaid prescription insurance plans. Browning's has a large selection of Watkins products, including a variety of flavorings.